Let's start by creating a screen or an XD, what's known as an artboard. To do so, I want to come over here to the tool panel and select the artboard tool. Now, if I roll over this icon here towards the bottom, notice that I get a tooltip letting me know that it's the artboard tool, along with a keyboard shortcut. I'm going to go ahead and rely on that keyboard shortcut, so I'll come back here on the design canvas and just type the letter A on the keyboard, which changes my tool to the artboard tool. Notice that it also brings up a set of default artboard sizes that I could select from here on the right-hand side. If I come back onto the design canvas and click and release just inside this rectangle, it'll create an iPhone X artboard, which is the default size for the application. The next thing you'll notice is that the name of the artboard is pretty generic. I want to give it more of a custom name, so to do that, I want to switch over to the pointer tool. I can go back to the tool panel to do that, or type another shortcut key on the keyboard, in this case the letter V. This switches me over to that selection tool, where I can now come in and double-click on that generic title and add a name of my own. I'll go ahead and call it My Splash. And I'll hit Return on the keyboard, which saves that name. Next, I want to add some design content to my artboard. The first thing I'll do is come and change the background color. I want to make sure I have the artboard selected. If I happen to have clicked off, I can select it again by clicking once on the name My Splash. I can tell it's selected because the name now shows up in blue and there's a selection indicator for the entire artboard. From here, I want to come in and select the eyedropper tool. I have a shortcut key for that as well. If I type I on the keyboard, it'll bring up that eyedropper. From there, I want to click on the purple color behind the word Plant Vibes in that circle. That then applies the color purple to the artboard. Next, I want to add some additional content to the screen. Now, when you're working on your own design, you'll be able to add content in a number of ways that we'll cover later in this tutorial. For now, let's just copy the artwork from this artboard here on the right-hand side. To do that, I'm going to come with my selection tool and press and drag until I select all of the elements there on the right. Next, I'm going to come to the Edit menu, and in the drop-down, I'll select Copy. When I paste it, I want to paste it in the same X and Y location on the new artboard. So if I come in and select the name My Splash, when I come back to Edit and select Paste, it's going to paste the content in place, or that same location. This trick is going to work with a single artboard or many artboards if I select more than one at a time. As long as the selected artboards are visible to me on the design canvas, XD is going to paste the content into all of them. With that set, let's move on to step 2, where we add content from outside the application.